Okay, for Cognos, I wanted to say a word about short file names and field names which were used on the old mainframe computers. Here's the name of some of the most popular mainframe computers that were used in the 1960s and 70s, and they normally had a rule that a file name had to be 8 characters or less, and a field name had to be 8 characters or less, because memory was very expensive. So I created a couple of dummy files with names of less than 8 characters and fields of less than 8 characters to use for testing purposes. All right, so we'll go to our Deep Purple database here. Sorry, our Deep Purple package here, right, that we're using for testing purposes. Package is what you define in Framework Manager. No, sorry, project is what you define in Framework Manager, and package is what you publish, right? So we'll go to a database, and I want to add one of those sample files, right? So I think it was called ABC123. That was a typical naming format. 3 letters for the name of the subsystem, and 3 digits for the number of the file. Right, so here it is. This is the one that I created before the video started, and it's got the 3 fields in it. And again, names are less than 8 characters, right? So that's a typical naming convention of those days. Right, and I can run a test. Okay, so there's the values, right? And notice also that we did not have a date format in those days, so dates were stored in numeric fields. Sometimes they were stored in numeric fields with a two-digit year. And we all know what kind of problems that caused in the year 2000, right? So here's our definition, right? There's a select statement for that, right? So what I want to show you is when you move this definition to the business layer. So let's define in the business layer here. We'll create a query subject. See, first of all, normally I would call that ABC123, right? But since that name would be completely meaningless, not only to the user, but even to you yourself, I would append to it something that makes sense, right? So suppose it was sales transactions, right? Then I would type sales transactions here, right? That's so that you always know what it is. And the same thing here, when you pull the fields over like this, you can rename them, the names, to something that makes sense, right? So for example, let's test this. Okay, that could be a transaction number, this could be a description, and this could be a date, right? So when we go to the definition, you can clip on the ellipsis here, and then you can type here transaction, let's say trans null. Normally you would shorten the name, right? That's so that you don't have to type as many characters. We could call that trans null. See the name change there. And then we could call this one da 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 trans desk, like that. And we call this one. Trans date like that. Right? So, you see, I still have the original name there. So if anyone wants to trace back, if some program is not working, you want to trace back to the beginning to find out why it's not working, you still know what the original name is, so you can trace it back. But at the same time, you have a description so that you know what the field actually is. Right? So let's test that again. See that the names are there, right? Then you could also define your relationships if there was any relationships, right? Then you can take a shortcut. I'm going to say here, create shortcut, right? And then I am going to move the shortcut to the presentation layer. Then I'm going to rename it to take out the beginning part that says shortcut 2, right? And then I would publish the package. We can test that to see if it works. There's our test. Yeah, and it does work, right? So that is my recommendation on how to handle file names and field names of 8 characters or less from that you're inheriting from mainframe systems, right? Is to add a description to it that shows what the file is and what the field is, right? Because if you allow the user to see a name such as ABC123, they'll say, "What is this? I don't understand what this is," and then they will refuse to use the software, right? You give them a name that makes sense, like sales transactions, then they'll use the software, right? And at the same time, you have the part at the beginning so that you know that this comes from a mainframe file called ABC123, right? Because if you just called it sales transactions, then you don't know where it came, and it could take you days to trace back where it came from, especially if you're not the one that did it in the first place. A lot of times you walk into a job, somebody else set up the naming convention and they're not there anymore, or they don't want to help you. So therefore, if you want to be professional, that's the kind of name that you use. And thanks for watching.